destination. Every day, more than 23 million people travel, and over 3 million tons of goods is transported from one place to another on the Indian Railway Network, which is world's longest rail network under the single management. Railway is one of the most fuel-efficient mode for transportation of goods and passengers while producing the least carbon emissions as compared to road and air. However, the saturation of existing Indian Railways tracks are becoming one of the biggest challenges in growth of passenger and goods traffic. Because of rapid development in road infrastructure in India and increased share of finished goods, the share of freight carried by Indian Railways has declined from 86% in 1950-51 to 36% by 2011-12, even though the total freight traffic has grown significantly. India's golden quadrilateral connecting four metropolitan cities with its diagonals is the worst affected. Golden quadrilateral of rail network is just 16% of total rail network, but carries nearly 60% of total freight traffic. Appreciating these facts, Indian Railways decided to build dedicated freight corridors, or TFC, so as to segregate passenger trains from freight trains and thus generating sufficient capacity to meet increasing demand of both for passengers and freight trains. In a momentous decision, Government of India established a special purpose vehicle called Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India Limited, DFCCIL, on 30th of October 2006 for planning, construction, operation and maintenance of dedicated freight corridors. In the first phase, two dedicated freight corridors have been approved for construction spanning a total length of over 3,350 kilometers. The Eastern DFC, covering a distance of about 1,850 kilometers, will start from Sahnewal, Ludhiana, and will pass through the states of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Jharkhand before terminating at Dankuni near Kolkata in West Bengal. About 1500 km western DFC will start from Dadri in Uttar Pradesh and traverse through Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat and Maharashtra. This corridor will terminate at Jawaharlal Nehru Port in Mumbai.
This dedicated freight corridor that we have planned on eastern side as well as western side is going to change the scene completely, because most of our freight which is on eastern side will shift to eastern dedicated freight corridor, and the freight of container traffic which is going to JNPT port will shift to western freight corridor.
The DFC will come up with several distinct features for the first time in Indian Railway. Freight carrying capacity per train will go up to 13,000 tons from the current 5,000 tons. Maximum speed of goods trains will increase to 100 kilometers as against the current maximum speed of 75 kilometers on Indian Railways. Average speed of freight trains will get a major boost due to dedicated freight lines, and the average speed of freight train has been targeted at 70 km per hour against existing speed of approximately 26 km per hour. The length of goods train will be increased from 700 meters to 1500 meters. Timetabled movement of freight trains will be ensured. Electrified double-stack containers trains will be operated on the Western DFC. The system will facilitate running of roll-on, roll-off in electrified territory. Not just transporting of goods, the DFC network will support in providing complete logistics solution to its customers by attracting community partners to set up multimodal logistics parks and terminals along the corridor. Such logistics parks and terminals will facilitate value addition, including packaging, retailing, labeling, and palletizing, etc. The first and last mile connectivity in terms of door-to-door services will be provided to the